Hi. On today's episode of Kickdown Garage, we're going to be looking at something a little different than we normally do. We're stepping away from the motorcycles and the cars and everything else and looking at the small engines. Now, this engine has the lazy man choke, the auto choke, and basically it doesn't work. About a year after owning the mower, it stopped working. So what I'm going to try to do is attempt to put a manual choke in it because I don't feel like replacing the little wax capsule every year on it. That's all it lasted the first time, so assume that's all it's gonna last. So I wanna go and put a manual choke on, and then I don't have to worry about it anymore. So let's see how that goes. Yep, probably won't even run after this. All right. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is take off the old throttle lever, and we're gonna leave that on, but we just need the bolt here. I'm gonna put this new throttle lever right next to it, and that's gonna act as the new choke lever. Get that off here. Besides it not wanting to, it's gone. Besides it not wanting to start, it's a great running mower. Just need to get to, you know, that first critical point of, you know, running. And like I said, when I first got it, it ran great. And then over winter, it stopped. Over winter, you know, whatever happens to the, you know, the wax or whatever's in that thing, and didn't want to run. So now all I did is took the bolt off and put a longer one in. This is a 3.5 inch, which is way too long. Well, and of course the other one, I didn't even think about it, the other one is metric. So no, it's not going to go on. So I'll have to go grab one of them. But anyway, this will be coming back off anyway. Actually, probably sooner than later, since I should have put the cable in. It just wants to fall. So what I'm doing, I'm just going to put this on, kind of figure out how I'm going to run the cable down, and then to get the direction correct on the lever, oh for Pete's sake, there we go, to get the correction, or the orientation right on the lever here, that would be start, so I want that to be choke and that choke off. So I gotta see how the butterfly works on the carburetor to see if I need to come in from the front side or the rear of the carburetor to make sure everything works right. Okay, anyway, that should work pretty good here. So now, I'm gonna get the air cleaner off, find a nut for the back of that, and we'll get going. Where did that go? Okay, now that we got the cable mounted up on the handlebar, I'm gonna get in here and take this cover off, and cover should hold the carburetor and everything on, so when you pull it off, you want to be careful not to rip the gaskets that are behind it. Once we get in here, I'll show you what that choke looks like. Thank you.
Yeah, there's a
hose on back here too. Get that off. There we go. It's the gasket. Okay, here's the piece. See if you guys can see it, but the little pin's poking out, and when that pokes out, the choke comes on. Okay, we can get this stuff back on. Okay, now we gotta figure it out. Okay, right now I'm just putting it back together without all the plastic stuff just so I can see how everything works and then and get that cable hooked. So what they, so how it goes is once it heats up, this will push out, you know, push on the butterfly right there and open up for no choke or choke. So we should be able to just run this down. Back through here. I think if I just put a hole into the top. Okay, so I'm gonna go and drill a hole through the top of that. Just trying to make sure I get the right swing on it here. So we'll pull fine. Okay, one final look before I start it up. Here is where I said I was gonna tie in the manual choke right into the top of that thingamabob on the butterfly there for the choke. ran it out. And that's just the Z end on the end of the cable. Ran it through. Now initially I tried to just tie it right into here, but once the throttle opens all the way up, it does rub on the new choke cable, so that didn't work. So for a temporary permanent solution, I went and I just zip tied it on. It seems to be holding. And then it just runs right up. And right into here is the new one. You can see it, and I just picked this up at Menards, same thing as Home Depot or anything like that. And it's just a throttle cable and doesn't have the full throw as it normally would here, but it does open and close the choke all the way. So start, it's full choke on, and then about 3/4 of the way back where the turtle is the run. So I figured start would be good for choke on, because when you go to start it, you know, choke needs to be off. But there you have it, real quick look. Let's get it outside to run it. Okay, well, it's the next day. Moore had time to... Don't try to correct me. It's the next day, Moore's cold. So I wanted to show you guys a cold start with it to show you that this modification did work. Put the choke on all the way. Gas on all, or throttle up all the way. Gas is on.
Okay, set it right up. Back in the choke off. Choke's all the way off now. Back in the throttle down, just so you guys can hear me, but there you go. Now, it hasn't started like this since the first year I had it. Over the first winter, that wax mechanism, auto lazy start, Californianism thing stopped working. So it's taken 50 pulls every time to get her going. And well, there we go. Hopefully this will be the, you know, nice easy fix. Like I said, if you guys follow what I did, it should only take you about 15 minutes to do. If you have any questions, throw them in the comments. When I get a chance, I'll respond to them. And hopefully you guys like the video. We'll catch you next time.